No such file or directory. Say what? Are you trying to run an Arduino sketch and keep getting this error? Listen, don't sweat. It's actually a pretty common Arduino error message. In fact, this video was inspired by one of our members who got the error when working with the Arduino servo library for the first time. In this lesson, I'm going to show you two super easy fixes that will hopefully get you back on track in just a matter of minutes. And you might even be like, oh man, I can't believe I did that after you hear about the first fix. Stay tuned. Are you just getting into Arduino programming? If you'd like to get a jump start on your programming skills, check out Programming Electronics Academy membership program. We have got a whole series of courses that walks you step by step learning how to program Arduino and use all its interesting tools. Check us out at programmingelectronics.com or just follow the link in the description. Okay, error messages can be such a pain, but they're supposed to, you know, kind of tell us something about the error we made. So let's take a look at this one. If you look at the bottom portion of the Arduino IDE where the error message shows up, there's this handy little button that says copy error messages. And if you click on it, it copies the error message inside this little window to the clipboard on the computer. And what you can do is if you want to search for that error online, you can like paste it into Google, for example, and do a search, and that kind of helps you find the error. Or you could paste it into a forum if you're saying, hey, I've got this error message, so that can help. But for this situation, I've just copied it, and then I'm going to paste it into a text editor so we can take a closer look at what the error message is actually saying. So the very top part of the error just says, hey, this is the Arduino version I'm using, this is my operating system, and this is the board that I have selected. The next line actually starts getting into the error a little bit. The first thing it gives us is the name of the program. So in this case, the name of the program was Knob. 10 is the line number that the error was on. So if we go back to the Arduino IDE, we can see it actually highlights that line. Here's the number 10. On the left, these numbers are called the line numbers of the program. And they're a reference to help us find where different lines of code are. And so this is line 10 is where it's telling me the error is. 19 is a reference to how long that line of code is. So how many spaces is it or how many characters long is it? And then it tells us the actual error. It says servo.h, no such file or directory. Now, in your case, it might not say servo.h. It might be dht.h or i2c.h or something like that, .h. It doesn't have to be servo, and the solutions in this video should still apply. So why are we getting this error? Well, let's take a look at line 10 and see what it says. In this line, we're using this hashtag and then include or pound sign, whatever you want to call that. And then we've got a space, and then we've got this thing called, in this case, it's called servo.h. So when we verify this code, what this include line does is it tells the compiler, and the compiler is the part of the Arduino IDE that takes our code and it kind of like translates it into code that's going to work for the Arduino the microcontroller that's on the Arduino. So this line of code is going to tell that compiler, hey, for this program to work, you need to go get this file right here. It's called servo.h. Yep, that's right. This file right here, you need to go get that file so that this program can work because there's some stuff in this program that needs information from this file. So that's what include does. It says there's these other files that this program right here is going to require in order to run. It was like, let's say you had this little label making machine and you were trying to like run the label maker and print some labels. Well, the label maker, you have to like put in a little roll of labels maybe. And if you don't have that roll of labels, then your label maker isn't going to work. So maybe this program's like the label maker, and then, you know, the file you include here are the labels to it. You know, this is just some dumb example there. That's a little crazy. Anyway, okay, hopefully you get the idea. This file is where we're saying, hey, we need this program. So this error message is like, hey, programmer, you said I needed this other file, but I looked for it and it's not there. Hey, what gives? So let's get to the bottom of this error message. And what we're going to do is go over two different scenarios. So here's the first scenario. This is a program. The sketch that you're writing is one that you've written. So you're the one that actually wrote the include line. The first thing you're going to want to check, and this is the absolute easiest fix, is just double check your spelling. That's right. So maybe you spelled the name of the library incorrectly. And Even, for example, in this one, maybe you didn't capitalize the right letters. So servo.h should actually be a capital S, servo.h. Now in this example, you'll notice that the word servo changes color. And that's because the library name here is recognized as a keyword in the Arduino IDE. Now that might not be the case for all the libraries that you're using. So you can't use that color change as an absolute indicator, but it can be helpful. It is amazing to me how long you can stare at a line of code and miss something like a spelling or a capitalization error. But hey, trust me, we have all been there. So hey, check your spelling and check your case. That's all I had to do in this situation, and the program compiled fine. But let's say that you're Mr. or Mrs. Grammar and you don't spell stuff wrong and you didn't make that mistake. That's not the issue you're having. Let's go on to scenario two. So in scenario two, you've downloaded some code from the internet, or maybe you've copy and pasted some code from the internet and you're trying to run it for the first time and you're still getting this error message. So let's just assume that the original author of the program spelled the name of the library correctly. So we'll go ahead and skip that first troubleshooting step. Now, I mean, you don't know that for sure, but anyway, let's just assume they did it. The next step would be to verify that we actually have that other file that this program is calling for, and that we've got that file in the correct place. Because remember, that include line is saying, hey, there's this other file that you're gonna need. And if we don't have that other file in the right place, how is the Arduino IDE gonna know where to look? It won't. So we gotta make sure we got that file. So an easy way to check to see if you have that file is to be in the Arduino IDE and go to Sketch, Include Library, and you're gonna get this huge list right here. And what you wanna do is you wanna look for the name of that library, whatever that include statement was, you wanna look through it in this big, long list. And if you don't see its exact name in this list, that means that you do not have that library installed appropriately. So in this case, the include line is sdht.h. And when I go to Sketch, Include Library, I am not seeing it anywhere. So they're all in alphabetical order. That kind of helps. And again, I'm not seeing it in here. So how can I add this library? Well, there's lots of different ways to add libraries. We'll cover two of them real quick. First, the easiest one. If you go back to Sketch, you go to Include Library, and go to Manage Libraries, it's gonna open up a dialog box, and you can search for a library. So I'm just gonna go ahead and filter for this search. There's so many libraries, you're definitely gonna wanna filter. So notice, I'm typing the exact word that matches here. Here's one that looks like the appropriate library for this include line. So I'll go ahead and click install. It will let me know that it's installing the library and updating the list of libraries, and then it'll let me know, hey, it's installed. All right, so I'll go ahead and close that. Now I'm gonna double check. I'm gonna go up to Sketch, Include Library, and if I come down, that was in the S section, right? Their alphabetical order. Oh, there it is, sdt.h. Okay, so let me go ahead and try to verify this now, and it compiles. Okay, sweet. So I had a program, I had copied it from the internet or downloaded the program, but what I had never done was actually gotten the library and installed that library. So that's why I was getting that error message. So that's one way to add the library. Now, not all libraries are in this convenient little pop-up window when you go to manage libraries. There's tons of different ways to find Arduino libraries on the web. Often, you know, if you're downloading or copying a program from the internet, just go to the page where you got that program and see what library they're referencing. Maybe they have a link to, for example, GitHub, which is a place where people keep a lot of code libraries. And what you can do is download the library file for that program. Usually it is in a zip file package, like a .zip file. Once you've downloaded the zip file, you can go to the Arduino IDE, go to Sketch, Include Library, Add Zip Library. Now you just have to navigate to where it was you downloaded that. It lets you know down here that the library has been added to your libraries. Check Include Library menu. So now when I go to Sketch, Include Library, and that was that ADXL library that I had included. So there it is. So that's the second way to grab a library if you realize you didn't have it installed in the first place. Okay, well, those are two pretty straightforward and simple ways to correct this error. So the first one is, if you wrote the sketch, just double check your spelling in case maybe you misspelled the library. And then the second situation, if you copy that code or maybe you downloaded it from the internet, you just want to make sure that you actually have that library folder in the appropriate place. And we talked about two ways to grab the library folder and put it into your Arduino sketch folder. Well, hey, I hope this helped solve your error problems. If it didn't, please leave a comment at the bottom. Maybe we can make some other videos to cover other situations about this. I'd appreciate your feedback. It'd be great. And if you enjoy this kind of lesson, please do subscribe to the channel. We release on a regular basis videos very much like this. And if you really want to get a jump start with learning how to program Arduino and stuff like this, building your own kind of projects, you'll definitely want to check out Programming Electronics Academy. It's at programmingelectronics.com. We've got a membership program where you can join, and we've got all types of courses that kind of walk you step by step through the very beginning of programming all the way up to using interrupts and writing your own libraries and stuff like that. It's pretty cool. So anyway, have a great one, and I'll see you next time. Bye.